Hello, two guys in a cooler. Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome to a celebration of sausage 2020. This is a giant collaboration that we're doing with the two guys in a cooler channel, where we are making a sausage today, and they're doing a new sausage every day this month. And there's a whole bunch of other YouTube channels that are also getting in on this. So all of those links will be below in the description box. And our contribution is a breakfast sausage. Now, over the years on this channel, we have done a bunch of breakfast sausages, probably going all the way back to 2008. I really like breakfast sausage. So today I'm gonna combine a few things that I usually like with breakfast sausage, and that's apples and maple syrup. So we're gonna start out with this pork butt, and it's already had the skin taken off. So I'm just gonna cut this into strips and take out the bone. So I'm using pork, and there was a very little piece of the shoulder blade in there, so not much waste on this at all. And the idea is I'm using pork shoulder. I'm actually using pork butt because it has probably the best meat to fat ratio for sausages, and you want that to be about 70-30. So I'm going to cut this into strips, I'm going to put it into that bin, and I'm going to stick it in the freezer for about a half an hour so that it firms up before we move on to the grinder. So while the pork is chilling in the freezer, we'll get the rest of our ingredients ready. Now I've got the spices already measured out, and we'll go through those when I add them. But I'm also going to add a small onion and one apple. I've got about 5 pounds of pork. I'm kind of torn. I think I might add a second smaller apple, and it's completely up to you how much you add. And they're going to go through the grinder, so I'm not going to chop them too finely. I'm mostly just going to peel them and give them a rough chop. Okay, it is time to grind. Now, one of the keys to making sausage is always keep everything cold. The warmer stuff is, the warmer the meat is, the harder it's going to be to grind and get a good grind. So, we're going to grind up all of this pork. And I'm starting off here with a really coarse disc for the first grind. Okay, the last bit of pork going through the grinder. So this is the point where I'm going to mix in the spices. I'm going to put in salt, ground black pepper, sage, some hot red pepper flakes. I like a little bit of heat, kind of balances everything out, and some dried mustard powder. And again, the dried mustard powder is going to bring you some heat as well. And so I'll just give this a rough mix with my hands. And it's going to go through the grinder two more times, so you don't have to be crazy vigilant about getting it all mixed together. Just do your best for the first run through. Now, I'm going to stick this back in the freezer. While that's back in the freezer, I've unplugged the grinder, and I'm going to change from this coarse grinding disc to a much finer grinding disc. This one is 2 millimeters. I kind of like this for breakfast sausage. So, out comes the grinding wheel. In goes the new one. And we are ready to continue grinding. Now, on this run through the grinder, we're going to add the apples and the onions. So, I might just throw a couple of those in there just to start. And the coarsely ground meat goes into the hopper, and away we go. When you're making sausage, you're going to end up washing your hands a lot because you use your hands. It's the best mixer. So the next ingredient is the maple syrup. Now I've got this super dark late harvest maple syrup that I like to use. And for this amount of meat, I'm going to say somewhere between a third and a half a cup of maple syrup. So let's get that measured out. There we go. And now we'll just mix this in. Put that under for the next operation. I'm going to mix this in by hand, and once I've got it all mixed in, we're going to put it back through the grinder on the fine blade one more time. This is also the point where you should judge whether you need to add liquid. The apple and the onion are going to add quite a bit of liquid. You're going to be surprised how much, actually. And you may not need to add any, and I'm pretty sure with this one I'm not going to need to add any. But if you do need to add a little bit, you can add water, you could add apple juice, you could add white wine, you could add milk. And just start out with a couple of tablespoons and see where that goes. Okay, you know what? This looks to be about the right consistency to me. I'm just going to stick this in the fridge while I get the stuffer ready. No need to go through the grinder a third time. And now for my least favorite part of the sausage making experience, and that is stuffing them. So I use this sausage stuffer now. I used to use the actual grinder and put the funnel on the front. When you're working alone, this is a much easier way to do it. So you want to put the sausage meat into the stuffer tube, and you don't want to get any air pockets in there. You want to get it packed in as tightly as possible. And I know some people wind up and throw it from great height to get it in there. I just put it in a little bit at a time and tamp it down. And this stuffer takes 7 pounds of stuffing. So with 5 pounds of meat, it fits in here just right. Okay, into the stuffer, and I just crank this down just until the sausage comes out the front. Okay, now I'm going to thread the casing onto the stuffer. And I'm using sheep casing today. It's not my favorite. I find it to be really, really, really fiddly because it's so tiny. But it gives you that great classic small-sized breakfast sausage. Okay, and now that I'm down to the end, just tie a knot, just a simple knot. And it can sometimes be a little bit difficult because it's really slippery. Bring that right to the end, and now we're making sausage. Of course, the trick here is to stuff it firm enough, but not overstuff it to the point where you get a blowout. And it's something that if you do it every day, if you did this every day for a job, you could probably make this seem so easy. But you know, for me, who does it every once in a while, it can sometimes be a little bit tricky, and it really doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. So I'm stuffing these into sheep casing, but you don't need to if you don't want to. I will often use pork casing, which is much bigger, easier to use, easier to stuff, I find anyway. And a lot of people will make this into a chub and then freeze it in a 1 pound chub. And then you just slice off rounds and cook the rounds for breakfast. I'll also take what's left in the stuffer at the end and just put that into a plastic container, put it in the freezer, and then use it at Thanksgiving and Christmas time for my stuffing. Okay, so here we go on the second casing. First one went pretty well. And it's hard stuffing for camera because my hand wants to be here, which would block you from seeing everything. There's just a little bit left in here. I'm going to put that into plastic containers and just freeze it without putting it into casings. The casings themselves, I'm pretty lazy. And so I usually just take a coil like that and vacuum seal it and freeze it and then just cook that as an entire coil. But I know that a lot of people will want to make them into individual sausages. And so you can just pinch them off to the length you want and twist them. And it takes a little bit of getting used to. First time you do it, you're going to be kind of like, do I really want to do this? It's not that difficult. It just takes a little bit of practice at the beginning, and then you've got it. So you can make them any length you want. And once I've got the links made up, I will put them onto a tray with a rack. And I'm going to stick these in the fridge overnight. And then tomorrow I'll come back and I will vacuum seal them. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glen. Hey, friends.
Sausages. Breakfast okay. Sausages. Okay.
I got porks. That's a great smell. Is it maple-y?
Yeah, so these are maple and apple pork breakfast sausages. Okay.
Thank you.
A couple of smaller pieces.
Always the more bite size. Smells really good.
Mm-hmm.
So you've heard me say before that I don't really like breakfast sausages, but this one does not have those strong breakfast sausage flavors. So it's perhaps, the other flavors, those sweet flavors, are they're winning. So for me, yay!
Mm-hmm. It's not overpowering on the sage.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes breakfast sausage can be overpoweringly sage. This is a little more balanced, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's not overly sweet, but you can tell that there's some sweetness there.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
It's a bit like when you have a little bit of maple syrup, because mm-hmm. you're having pancakes and sausage, and that little bit of maple syrup gets mixed into it.
It gets mixed in, and
it's got that great flavor already there.
Yep. So I think this is a winner, and I want to thank Two Guys in a Cooler for inviting us to participate in this YouTube collaboration. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.